yoga instructor in your life. I spoke a little bit earlier as we were gathered in a circle, thanking all of these wonderful now yoga instructors that get to go and do what we desire to do, and that's to make a difference wherever we go. I decided to take this training because I am a life coach, and I primarily deal with women that need to be supported in the areas of growth, and I also coach cancer families or families affected by cancer, their caregivers, the patient, and I teach them how to actually live through cancer so that when they hear the words "you have cancer," they don't automatically just think that. And I'm very, very accustomed, and I believe in the power of breathing, the power of meditation, the power of how the body moves and how it heals you. And so when I came across this training, I thought, what better way to learn more ways of challenging people to heal, challenging people to become their greater self, and then to have a yoga certification to back me up, to make me more credible in the eyes of others, but more importantly, to show people that through their movement, when they align movement and breath, they begin a whole other healing that their body and their mind and their spirit and their soul may not have otherwise thought could ever happen. So that is why I took this course. And coming in, when we first got here, there's this room full of people, and day by day it dwindled down just a little bit more, just a little bit more. And that was okay, because we always wish people well wherever they are in their life. But to the instructors that are here, and yes, I'm calling you instructors because you are no longer students, you are instructors. You were meant to be here at this time from January 20th until now. If you were supposed to come last year, maybe you thought you were going to come next year, maybe you thought you were going to come in the summertime, now was your time by divine. Now was your time by spirit. Now was your time for your growth. And you know that because when we came in, many of us didn't know each other. I actually found out I knew two people here once I got here. But if you came here and you didn't know anyone, you found your family when you found your community. You found your sisterhood, you found your friendships, you found lifelong partnerships, you found someone that you may end up opening a yoga studio with. You found who you were supposed to connect to, who you were supposed to be with, who you're supposed to grow with. And that was a beautiful thing. Aside of everything that we got to learn, it is about the relationships that we get to build from this day forward. So January 20th was only the beginning. All the lessons we learned along the way is really the preparation for what we get to do from this day forward. Whether you're going to open up a business, whether you're going to teach yoga in your practice, whether you're going to do something in your community, whatever it is, you're powerful enough, you're bold enough, you're brave enough, you're confident enough, you're awesome enough, you're intelligent enough, and if I can't say it enough, you are enough. He's going to teach you about the yamas. He's going to teach you about all these powerful teachers. To Diane, you are more incredible than you know. You gave us such a different perspective. Always reminding us where we were in the program and where we needed to be for this day. to our songbird Joe. Thank you for always giving us that encouragement through song, through music. Thank you for stretching us beyond what we knew. Thank you for being so earth-cautious and showing us what it means to be earth-cautious. I'm going to skip you for it. To Selena, you keep it real. 100 all the time. You push us into the social-emotional learning. You push us beyond what our biases are. You push us to know that no matter where we come from, we have a voice, and no matter who we're teaching, they have a voice, and how to connect the two in the most powerful, beautiful ways that we can with us. To the meditating king himself, we are.